Hi, this is Jessica with CutesyCrafts.com, and today we're going to be talking about needle threaders. I tried out several different needle threaders with several different size embroidery needles and different amounts of embroidery floss. The needles that I'm using are Tulip Hiroshima needles, so the results could be different based off of what type of needles you're using. Here I'm going to be using a size 3 needle for all 6 strands of embroidery floss, a size 8 needle for 3 strands of embroidery floss, and a size 10 needle for 1 strand of embroidery floss. I tested all of these needle threaders over and over again so that I could give you some honest feedback. The first one that we have is the Loran needle threader. This side is definitely too big to be used for an embroidery needle, could maybe be used for yarn. This side, however, was only able to fit my size 3 embroidery needle, and it was very difficult to pull the floss back through. However, it did work for 6 strands of floss and my size 3 needle. For the other 2 needles, this was useless. It wouldn't even fit through the eye of the needles. Next up, I have the Dritz looped needle threader, and it's basically this long, thin piece of wire with a big loop here and then a smaller little twist at the end. It's pretty flimsy, but the good thing is that it comes in a pack of 6. So even if you ruin one here and there, they're pretty inexpensive and you have 5 more. This one worked for my size 8 needle and my size 3 needle, but it did not work. It was too big for my small size 10 needle. Next up, I have the Clover double needle threader. This one had a smaller side with a wire for smaller needles and a larger side for larger needles. And while I did really enjoy using this one and I liked that it was big and I could grip onto it, it broke within a few uses. So this side, the wire came completely out, and this side, I don't know if you can see, but the wire broke at the tip and just completely, after it distorted, came apart. So this is not one that I can recommend. Next up is the Dritz LED needle minder, and this one was really cool because it had a wire that would come out and the light would come on. And I don't know if you can see, but no wire came out. That's because after a couple of uses, the wire got stuck down inside, and I did everything that I could and I could not get it to come back out. So cool concept. I really, really loved using it with the light. It helped me see the needle better to thread it. However, I can't recommend it because it broke so easily. Next up, this cute hummingbird needle threader from Dritz. It's got the little beak is the part that threads the needle. This one, although adorable, would be better used for only 1 strand of thread, and that's all that I was able to thread with this one, was 1 strand. So this could be good for like a sewing kit if you wanted to gift one to somebody with a cute little needle threader where you only will need 1 strand of thread or a thin strand of like sewing thread, but I cannot recommend this one for embroidery. Next, I had to try out these beautiful needle threaders from Puffin & Company. And they are magnetic, so if you have a magnetic needle minder, you can stick these to them, and I really liked that feature of them. The small one, I bought that one first, and it was only able to thread my size 10 and my size 8 needle. It was not able to get all 6 strands onto my size 3 needle. The hook on it was just too small. So I thought, okay, well, let's try out like the regular size one. This one's called the micro one, and this is the regular size one. So I tried this one out, and as soon as I bought it, I noticed that the hook is pretty much exactly the same size as the Loran needle threader, and the Loran needle threader is a whole heck of a lot cheaper. So I don't recommend get it. Well, I mean, I guess you could. You could get both of these and then you'd be able to thread all of the needles. However, if you don't want to spend the amount of money, you could just get the Loran needle threader or even the Dritzt looped needle threader, plus this little guy here, and then you'd be able to thread all of the different sizes of needles. Also, something else to know about this, if you have a dexterity problems, this is pretty small. I kind of almost wish that the hook was on something bigger like this so that I could get my whole hand around it. So when you're putting thread on the needle, you've got to first get that little hook through there anyway and then manage to kind of wrangle the thread around, and I'll show you. This is 3 strands of floss. You have to put that around while also holding onto your needle with the same hand. And it can get a little bit tricky because this kind of needs to be held tight and then pull that through at the same time. And it can take a little finagling and then it goes through eventually. And then also with the larger one, just like the Loran one, it is really hard to pull. You have to put a lot of force on pulling this through, and I actually ended up bending the hook a little bit on that one. So just keep that in mind if you have some dexterity issues, and then these might not be a good option for you. And then finally, I was super excited to try out the Bohin Easy Needle Threader. It's an automatic needle threader, and I'm not going to go through exactly how to use it. I'll have another video that I will link to in the description that'll show how to use this guy. But it was able to successfully thread my 2 smaller needles with a smaller amount of thread. Once I put 6 strands of floss through with my size 3 needle, it couldn't pull all of them through at the same time. So this is definitely one that would be good for someone who had dexterity problems or maybe arthritis. I hear from a lot of people that used to love embroidery and they can't anymore because maybe their eyesight isn't so good or their hand dexterity isn't as good as it used to be. This is definitely something that would work for you. So to get around the fact that this one and some of the other ones can't thread all 6 strands of floss, I'm going to show you a little trick. So instead of taking all 6 strands, take only half, take 3, and you want to cut the length of your thread twice the amount that you normally would. And then what you'll do is take your needle. So I'm going to take my size 3 needle for 6 strands, and I'm going to thread that. And let me just show you with the Loran needle threader so I can show you how to pull that one through. So I'm going to thread 3 strands on there, and it actually should go through easier because I'm only using 3 strands on a bigger needle here. So that went through pretty easily. And then what you would do is pull the strings all the way through until they're both even at the other side. And then you would, so you're doubling them up. And then you would tie a knot in the end down here. So you've only had to thread 3 strands through here. However, you have 6 strands total to work with. So that could definitely be something that would help you in threading a needle, especially when so many of these can't handle all 6 strands of floss. So to sum up, this one's a no, this one's a no. Also, Hummingbird is a no. If you have dexterity issues, the Bohin needle threader is going to be your friend. And use my little trick on doubling up your thread if you need to be able to use 6 strands but only thread 3. For everyday use, I would suggest a combination of the needle threaders here. If you have good dexterity and you want a cute little needle threader, you could definitely go with this Puffin & Co. one. You could either get both different sizes, this one for all 6 strands and this one for anything smaller, or you could just get the one and then use the trick to double up the thread when you need to use all 6 strands but only want to thread 3. If you want to be able to thread all 6 strands, you'd have to either get this one and this one, both sizes of the Puffin & Company needle threaders. Or you could get, if you wanted to go cheaper, since these are essentially the same size, you could get the cheaper Loran needle threader and the small Puffin & Company needle threader. Or you could get the looped needle threader and the small Puffin & Company needle threader, because remember, this one cannot do the smaller one strand of embroidery floss. As for me, I find myself kind of not really using this one as much, mostly using the small Micro Puffin & Company needle threader, and occasionally when I need to use all six strands, I've been using this looped needle threader. I really hope that this review of needle threaders was helpful for you. If you can get away with not using a needle threader, I feel like that's really going to be your best bet. It can be hard at first, but practice is going to make perfect with that. And if you're having trouble with the six strands and you don't have a needle threader, you can also use the double up technique for that. I've linked to all of these needle threaders in the video description below, and I've also written a blog post about it that I'll link to in case you like to read about things rather than see them visually and hear them. Head over to my blog, cutesycrafts.com, for more embroidery tips and free patterns.